Hi everyone, I am Laura and welcome to Blasting Through Lockdown. Over lockdown, like many of you, I'm sure, I was super bored. And I was so bored that I tried loads of different things to try and get me something to do. I reorganized my wardrobe into color coordinated order. I did lots of baking. Of course, I made banana bread. I made some scones and some buns and cakes. I went on lots of walks. To my shame, I downloaded TikTok and did them silly dances. And I even took up running. That is how bored I was. I was trying out all these new things to keep myself occupied, to find something fun to do in lockdown. But I find that whenever I was finished one thing, I was just thinking about what I was going to do next. Whenever I finished baking, when something was in the oven, I was already thinking about what I was going to bake next. Whenever I received a parcel in the post from my online shopping, I was already thinking, what else can I order? What will this go with? Whenever I was just back from a run or a walk, I was thinking, right, when are we going next? When are we getting out of the house again? All these things were fun for a little while. They occupied me for a few hours, but whenever they were done, I was left wanting more. They weren't permanent. They were a temporary source of satisfaction. And not just in lockdown, in life, we are always searching for the next big thing. The thing that will make us happy, that will satisfy our needs, that will leave us wanting nothing more. We sometimes say, if I just had them clothes or that car or that amount of money, then everything will be perfect. I'll be satisfied. We think, if I had that friendship group, if I had that boyfriend or girlfriend, if I had that perfect family life, then that would be me. I would be satisfied. And then when we finally get that thing, we're happy for a while, it's great for a while, and then we kind of lose interest. The shine starts to wear off and we're at it again. We're searching for something more. We want more. We need something else to make us happy, to make us satisfied. There are so many things that the world tells us that we need to be and have to be happy. That we need to have a certain amount of money, we need to be successful, we need to look a certain way, dress a certain way, be a certain weight, have a certain set of grades, to have a fulfilled life, to have the maximum happiness that we can have. For me, it's always been my grades. I was definitely a nerd at school, and I always thought that if I could just get certain test scores, certain grades, if I could get into that uni course, get that job, then I would be happy. All these things that we look to for our satisfaction and happiness can all be gone in the blink of an eye. They're all temporary. Jobs and money can be gone just like that. Our looks fade, they don't last forever. Our friends can be here one day and gone the next. And when all these things go, what is left behind? What do we have left? It's easy to think that without all the material things that we need to live comfortably, that we can't have a happy life. But I want to read to you from Philippians chapter 4. And whenever Paul writes this, he is in jail. He has absolutely nothing. And this is what he says. I know what it is to be in need, and I know what it is to have plenty. I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want. I can do everything through him who gives me strength. By our standards, Paul had very little. He had no riches, no house, no freedom. He had more enemies than friends. So how could he be so content with what he had when he had so little? Because what he did have mattered so much more than what he didn't have. He had eternal life. He had forgiveness of sins. He had a home in heaven. When everything else was stripped away, all that was left was Jesus. And that was enough for him. What he had in his life with God was so much greater than what he didn't have in his life in the world. And that was his source of peace and joy and satisfaction that no one could take away from him. True joy can't be found in a person or a possession, and if we look for it there, we'll never find it. True and lasting fulfillment and happiness in life can only be found through Jesus.